folks, it's Jared Manninen from the website TahoeTrailGuide.com. Today I'm going to provide a little bit of an FAQ type of a video. I'll try to keep it short and brief, but there's a question that I've been getting asked a lot this season, and it's regarding whether or not you could use the same set of boots for both a set of off-track and on-track cross-country skis. The technical answer to that is yes, but it's predicated on having the same type of binding system, which should be relatively obvious to most people. The inherent problem with this option, though, is that the binding systems used for classic or even skate skiing at groomed terrain are usually really lightweight. Currently, the most popular or most common one is an NNN compatible binding, which is New Nordic Norm. And those bindings are pretty lightweight. That's not to say that you can't ski hard at groomed resorts. Obviously you can. You can go fast, up, down, flat, making turns, coming to a complete stop. The reason that they're light duty is that, generally speaking, at a groomed cross-country ski area, the snow is uniform. It may be up and it may be down, but overall the snow is firm. It has a really solid base to it, so you're not dealing with traditionally variable conditions. Obviously, you could get fresh snow while you're skiing at a groomed resort. Now it's sort of variable terrain, but realistically, with that firm base, you never have to worry about breaking through crust or having to negotiate really deep snow. So those light duty bindings that you would use at a groomed resort are not super applicable to the off-track or backcountry environment. And the reason I say that is, again, you're dealing with variable conditions, so inherently you're going to be placing more pressure on those bindings, trying to get them to turn or to slog through really challenging snow conditions like crust on top of unconsolidated sugary snow where you're breaking through and your skis are underneath. So if you want to do any kind of turning or manipulation of those skis, it's going to be really challenging with a lightweight binding system. Now, I understand completely why people would want to just buy one set of boots and then have those be useful for both sets of skis. The reality is, if you're going to invest in two sets of skis and one is going to be for a groomed resort and the other is going to be for the backcountry, you can put those lightweight bindings, like an NNN binding, on an off-track ski, but generally speaking, you're only going to want to put that on a ski that's maybe at most 70 millimeters wide. The reason for that, again, is because if you have this really wide off-track cross-country ski and you put this little tiny binding, it's just going to be dwarfed on that ski, and as a result there's going to be a lot of pressure that you put on those bindings and that little teeny binding to get those big skis to move around and turn and negotiate that variable condition. And that's just a recipe for disaster. You end up putting a lot of pressure on the binding to the point where it can snap off or come out of the screw holes that it's in just because of the nature of the thing. I don't know how many people sew out there, but it's a similar concept to using a commensurate sized thread or gauge thread with the fabric in which you're sewing. You don't want to put super heavy duty thread with a lightweight fabric, because what it'll do is it'll perforate the fabric and tear, right? Or use a super heavyweight fabric and use a really lightweight thread, because then the thread will rip before the fabric does. You want to have it like marry or find some sort of unity or harmony. I technically do have a set of NNN bindings on the off-track or backcountry cross-country skis that I'm running today, but those off-track skis are only 62 millimeters wide, so I could technically use that one ski both out here in this firm consolidated snow and then at a groomed cross-country ski area, and I could still fit in those tracks. So this question is usually the follow-up question that I receive after people watch my other video about whether or not you could use one set of skis for both application on and off track. In that video, I highlight the fact that the narrow off-track skis are not super versatile in variable conditions and deeper snow. And I'm using these same exact skis in that other video. So that would be like the one ski that you could use in both environments, but you're not really getting a great experience with this one ski in either of the environments, because it's not truly a track ski and it's not truly an off-track ski. It's kind of just in the middle of both. If you're looking to already invest in two sets of skis and two sets of bindings and just buy one set of boot, again, if you go ahead and buy a great ski with an Manninen binding, for example, for classic use at a groomed cross-country ski area, get some nice, comfortable classic boots for that. If you're gonna then buy an off-track ski, just go all in and buy a good wider backcountry cross-country ski. Generally speaking, 75 to 90 millimeters is a great all-around width for an all-mountain kind of a cross-country ski. And then invest in good boots that have higher ankle support, because you don't need all of that boot to run classic skis at a groomed cross-country ski area. Again, you're dealing with firm conditions, you wanna be lightweight. You don't need heavy duty gear, the same gear that you might use in the off track or backcountry environment at a groomed cross-country ski area. It's just too much ski, too much boot, too much binding. Just go ahead and get a good set of classic track skis that you can really grow into for groomed terrain, and then get a nice comfortable classic boot to go with it, and then invest in a good off-track or backcountry cross-country ski with an Manninen BC binding, for example. That's the backcountry version of the new Nordic Norm binding. Keep in mind that neither of those two are compatible. Manninen and Manninen BC, they're separate. The Manninen BC has a wider, more robust bar on it, and usually the platform, whether you're getting the auto binding or the manual version of Manninen BC, is wider. You wouldn't want to put that binding on a track ski that you would use at groomed resort. Again, too much binding for that application. It's just too much. So get that on a wider off-track ski and invest in a good set of boots for use in the off-track environment. Again, something a little bit taller and more robust, maybe more waterproofing, warmer, a little bit more ankle support. Just get the right tool for the right job is all I'm saying. I know it's gonna probably cost a little bit more money, but you're gonna have a great experience in both environments instead of trying to just, again, save yourself $200. You can get a great pair of off-track backcountry cross-country ski boots for, you know, $250 or less, depending on what brand that you get. But Manninen BC is super universal. You can find that type of boot and just about every manufacturer's line of cross-country ski boots. So that is what I would recommend. If you do end up getting a super wide cross-country ski like those 112 millimeters that I use a lot of times in my videos, then you may want to look at getting a more standard 3-pin binding. But if you're getting anything between a 75 and 90 millimeter off-track ski, an Manninen BC binding is going to be great for you. Just know that I don't really recommend using the same type of boot for both application. I can classic ski in those bigger off-track beefy boots with a lot of support, but at the same time, I'd much prefer a lighter boot if at all possible, and that's what I would want to use at a groomed resort, is a lightweight classic boot dedicated just for classic cross-country skiing. It's comfortable, it allows a lot of ankle flexion, whereas those off-track and backcountry ski boots are a bit stiffer and have more, just more of everything, and they're heavier, so. All right, that's all I wanna say. I could keep going on and on, but you get the point. Get the right tools for the right jobs, and in this case, it means if you're investing in both sets of gear, go ahead and get those better boots and those better bindings for your off-track experience. And honestly, it actually extends the life of those boots as well, because you won't be using that same pair of boots for everything that you do in the winter. That's one of the reasons why I buy as much gear as I buy, because it spread loads the amount of effort or work they all have to endure. It's also a justification for me to buy more gear. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. Post any questions or feedback about this conversation in the comment section below. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. check out tahotrailguide.com. And specifically, if you want to learn more about Manninen BC auto and manual bindings, as well as a basic 3-pin binding, I have an article specifically about those bindings on tahotrailguide.com. I also have a Patreon account and a paypal.me button if you feel compelled to contribute in a financial way to the health and longevity of Tahoe Trail Guide and this YouTube channel. I totally appreciate it. Yeah, take care, have a great rest of your winter, and we'll see you next time.
GoPro stop capture.